A beckoning public date has continuously raised concerns among members of the public as they point to the need to widen the tax base to reduce borrowing. Finance Minister Matia Kasaija recently put Uganda's public debt at 80.8 trillion shillings, an equivalent of $21.7 billion as of end of December 2022.
The question of widening the tax base, you the accountants, you need to help us. There seems to be more demand than what we should use to facilitate the demand, thereby calling for widening of the tax base. Budget discipline has been highlighted here.
This economy is driven by SMEs. And SMEs are the engine that are going to move us forward if we can only formalize those SMEs and get them growing. And this is where the accountants come in. Accountants are able to provide that support for SMEs to formalize their businesses, to do proper record keeping, and therefore be able to collect whatever taxes are due for government, and therefore reduce the gap that we have in terms of domestic revenue.
Government Chief Whip Hamson Oboa tasked the Institute of Certified Public Accountants of Uganda to come up with proposals on how to widen the domestic tax base. Oboa was delivering a keynote address during the 11th Institute of Certified Public Accountants of Uganda Economic Forum, held under the theme National Priorities for Socio-Economic Development in Entebbe.
And for these SMEs, yes, they may want to stay in the informal sector, but there are benefits for them in getting into the formal sector. And one of them is to be able to expand their businesses and get even cheaper capital, and therefore be able to create production in this economy and to grow. If we are to achieve the 7% growth that we are looking at, we need to ramp up our production. And therefore, it's about advocacy, it's about educating them the benefits. Right now, they are on the side where they do not know the other benefits that are going to come by joining.
However, several efforts towards persuading small and medium enterprises to formalize remain futile as owners fear it will still kill their businesses in the long run. ICPAU President Josephine Osia now says that they are working with the Kampala City Traders Association to persuade the business community to formalize their businesses. Story by Benin Ojambo for the news.